What is up, everybody? What's going on? How you doing? This is Albert from Albert Christoph channel, and today this video is something different. It's basically I got this camera off of eBay. I guess I wanna show you how to buy clean or somewhat CLA, a used film camera that you can buy off of eBay or Craigslist or whatever. So this is what I got, and for the price that I got it for, it's not that bad. Came with a strap, the leather thing, and a case. It came with a case, so not bad. And I got it for $30. So today I'm gonna show you what to look for when buying something, and I guess I'm gonna clean this and show you guys what we got. Alright, so let's take out all this stuff. So when I got this, I saw this on eBay and I was like, you can't really test this, you know? So you're just gonna have to go by the description and ask questions. Always ask questions if you have any. And let me just take off the leather. So right there, so this is the Canon TX, and it's a 35 millimeter film camera. It even has a filter, which I'll probably, I'm gonna give this as a gift to somebody, and I'm not gonna keep this, but I'm gonna test it. And before sending it, so when you're buying something like this, you might want to check most of the functions mainly. All right, let's check the lens first, the mirror. Make sure everything's good. The lens overall is okay. It's not that bad. And I think you can't remove this. It has a filter, so I don't know if you can remove it. I was told you can't, but since it's clean, I'm just not gonna touch it. I'm just gonna wipe the top off, and maybe the rear, but probably not. So when you're buying these things, make sure you look at the mirror and make sure it's there. There's no crack or whatever. So you just check, make sure it's there. But this is not a big deal. You can clean that off and replace it. I don't know if you can see it somewhere inside. Some kind of foam. But this one, I can see that it's non-existent, or there's just dirt on it and stuff. So let's go check out the other side, which is, let's see, this one. Let's open it. That's the shutter curtain. So we're going to check to see if it's fully working. So let's start with, I don't know, 500. Make sure it rewinds and then it opens. And it's pretty fast, so you can't really see it. So let's go, I don't know, 60. The second. I still can't see, but it did. So let's try 1 second. So this might work. Make sure everything turns, the knobs and stuff. So let's go. So that's a second. Let's try bulb. And it works. See? It looks fine. So all the shutter seems to be working. That's the ASA. You can adjust it to whatever ASA you want. Right there, 200, or it's kind of hard to move it, but yeah, it's working. So shutter works, advanced lever works. I can see this thing moving whenever I advance the film. Shutter curtain works, the mirror absolutely work. And I'll show you the mirror. This is bulb, so it does work. So it looks like this just needs cleaning, so I'm gonna clean everything. and I'll show you guys how to do that. So the main problem with this is, normally from experience, is this, because that's where the light seal, I guess, from both sides of the camera, from this hinge. So I can see that this is, well, it's almost gone. So I'll see if I can replace that. And I probably don't even want to test and waste a couple of rolls, because I think I kind of know that there might be a light seal. For now, let's clean the camera itself. What I have here is just a, you know, paper towel, alcohol. So I'm just going to clean the overall body of the camera. Make sure it's clean, and I don't think it has been clean for a long time. This camera, it looks like it's really dirty. So basically I'm just wiping everything, all the dust and the particles on the camera. Make sure it's okay to handle. It looks like, yeah, it's kind of dirty. Clean the lens also, just the side. Make sure you wipe it thoroughly so it'll be clean when you use it. And this part, I'm not gonna touch it, and this part because I don't want to scratch it, but hey. So it looks like I need to clean this part just a little bit. The mirror seems okay, so I'll just wipe it off a little bit. And basically this part of the camera, I'm going to clean and then replace it with some kind of foam that you can get anywhere. I usually use a black of this stuff, but to show it to you, I'm gonna use this red, bright red. So I'm gonna put it right there, and I'm gonna replace this one too. Maybe put it like that. I'll show it to you. So let's go start cleaning this camera. So I'm gonna start cleaning this, because this is the hardest thing to clean, this one. So I'll show you how to do it. So I got some alcohol on the cotton bud, and basically I'm just gonna clean this. It has a gooey consistency. See, it's all crap. Well, I have my FTB, and you know, I had to run like a roll of film on it to find out that it has a light leak. So you just kind of want to just go ahead and change it, you know, because you kind of know that it's gonna have light leaks, so might as well fix it before you test it. So you just clean it like so. And you want to get the gunk off like really good, because we're gonna replace it with some kind of foam, and you want that to stick there. So now that I got the gunk out of this hinge, it's fairly clean, and I think my sticker, or this one, will actually stick to this now. So basically it's where the mirror slaps. There's no foam on it anymore, so when the mirror hits this part, you don't want the mirror to basically break. So I'm just gonna put some kind of cushion in this part, so I'll show you guys how to do that. So I'm just gonna take the Q-tip and just slightly brush this. Now, I don't recommend doing this to an expensive camera, but something you just buy off of eBay, something simple as this mechanical camera. I mean, it only cost me $30, so it's not really, gonna affect me if this thing doesn't work or I did something wrong or but you kind of want to be careful with it a little bit and actually just, just take care of it as you clean. But, it's a good way to learn and experiment a little bit on how to handle like this kind of cameras. And yeah. And this is how I actually learned. Like the first time I bought my FTV, the Canon, I just wanted to return it. I just wanted to sell it because it didn't work. I mean, it had light leaks, it's dirty, but you just have to clean it and just do your best, And hopefully everything works out, then it works. But this one, the good thing about mechanical cameras are, as long as the shutter works, the mirror works, the shutter curtains, works, you should be pretty good. So, yeah. So since I'm here, I'm just gonna clean the mirror. Just basically just wiping the top coating of the mirror. Don't put too much pressure on it. You're just cleaning it. Just be gentle and you should be okay. And yeah, that's fine. I think I'm almost done with this part. I think it's almost cleaned. Alright, so now I'm just gonna put this back on. Make sure to protect the mirror and all that stuff before I work on the light leaks. So basically, I'm gonna measure this. Make sure you measure this just about there. So I'm just gonna shape this to something that match this part of it so I can stick it in there. So basically, this is just to prevent light from going into your film. So that's about, it seems right. It fits. So I'm just gonna stick it in there. Right there. Just like that. Yep, perfect. Like so, and that will prevent the light from coming into the camera. See, just like that, and that's pretty fast. See, it's already done. Hopefully, this will stay there, but I know it'll stay there, it'll work, and that should fix that problem for the film light leaks. Now, there's another one on this side. This you don't really have to replace it, but every time the mirror flaps, it hits this part of the camera, and it's a sensitive, the mirror is one of the sensitive part of the camera, so you want to prevent that from happening. So basically, I'm just gonna put this on the top edge and it'll serve as a some kind of cushion on the camera. So let's go do it. So I'm gonna use the same part, almost the same part that I used that I took from the previous one, and this should do okay. I mean, yeah. So it's just gonna be that part, top part of it. So there you go. So I kind of put that on top of the mirror. Now it doesn't look like professionally done. So if you are a person who is very thorough and, you know, perfect and all nice, you might want to cut this nicely. I mean, with a new strip. But this one with mine, it's just as long as it works, you know. And I think this will do the job. And I will actually test it out and see if it works. So let's go try it out. So let's advance the film. I'm gonna put this in bulb so I can show you guys. Ready? See how that thing flaps on top? Basically, the cushion is protecting the mirror. I'll show you guys again. Now, you can use a black one so it looks better, but with me, I don't care. I mean, it looks fine. So one more. There we go. That looks good. So I think that's it. It should be working. And I'll show you what I did on the inside again. So I kind of put that buffer back to protect the light from coming in, and I think the rest of it looks fine. So this is the only thing that concerns me, but it looks okay. So let's test it out and see if it works. Everything works. I mean, you can't see it because I have a lens, but yeah, it's the shutter curtain opens. Everything works. It looks okay. Alright, close it back out, and it's ready for film. So I'm just gonna clean up and do a test shot, and I'll post some pictures, and hopefully you guys can see the difference, or can see how it is, and maybe you guys can buy stuff like this, old film cameras. I mean, actually reusing camera. I mean, old cameras like this. I mean, this one looks perfectly okay. It just needed some TLC or CLA, but I'm not gonna send this off because I only purchased this for $30, and this kind of cameras, you don't really want to spend too much on it because, you know, basically it's a user camera, and a lot of people don't actually buy this because the meter doesn't work, because I don't even know if they have batteries for this. So, but yeah, I cleaned it, and I'm gonna test it, and I'm gonna show you guys some pictures, and hopefully this encourages you guys to actually purchase film camera. Canon TX is a pretty good camera. It's all mechanical. That's the most important part in this camera. And this is a pretty good solid camera. Any working camera is a good camera. That's what I say. So, you know, if you have something laying around the house, your parents have some, or you're thinking of buying one, you know, go for it. It's not that expensive. And basically you're saving something that people cherish and use a lot before. And yeah, it's a pretty solid camera. And yeah, so hopefully this encourages you guys to buy film cameras, support film. And just remember, any working camera is a good camera. So there you go. That's what's up. Oh, I should have did it this way, huh? Oh, okay. Anyways.